Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be looking at the fuel system on our 2007 Suzuki GSX-R1000. Specifically, this one doesn't want to prime up. Turn it on, you hear the actuators, but you should also hear the actual fuel pump building up pressure, and that's not happening with this unit. So, let me go grab a couple of tools, and we'll start digging into this thing and see what's going on. All right, guys, this is going to be a skill level one, so it's really not going to be that tough, and there's not that many tools required. You will need to go get a good voltammeter, a test light, 3/8 ratcheted as always, an extension, and a 5mm Allen. Now, as far as the parts, if you would reference our parts diagrams, this gives you an exploded look of where everything is and how it comes apart, and more importantly, how we're going to put it back together. So once you have your tools and your parts together, we can go over there and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, guys, let's start off by looking at our fuel pump relay. It's this one right here. Initially, just lift it up. And just with your fingers, you should be able to feel it click if it's actuating at all. Yeah, I can feel it. And then cut back off. Because normally what you would hear is you would turn it on, it would prime up the pump for maybe a second or two, and then shut off. Because it doesn't run continuously, it just brings up the pressure to 43 pounds and just keeps it there and only cuts on if it starts falling below. So I believe this one is actuating. And the color that we're looking for is on the bottom side. It is yellow with a red stripe. That should go active for maybe a second or two and then shut off. Well, let's see what she's doing. Ground our test light, get on that one wire. Let's see if she's triggering. All right, there it is. And then off. All right, so that tells me we're getting power to the relay and the relay is then sending power up to the fuel pump itself. So it looks like we're gonna have to dig a little bit further. Let's put our relays back where they were, where they don't get damaged. And then we're going to lift the tank up and verify that there actually is power going through the harness up to the connection that leads into the fuel pump itself. All right, there's our yellow with a red stripe. And one side of that's going to be a ground, and the that third wire actually goes to the fuel level sensors inside the tank. But the only one we really care about right now is that yellow with a red stripe. So we're going to unplug it and see if we're getting voltage there when we turn on the key. And remember, once again, it's only going to be powered on for a couple of seconds, and then it's going to go off if it's working correctly. Yep, there it is. And now off. Plus, you can hear the relay clicking. So let's go ahead and get the tank disconnected and we'll put it over on the teardown bench and get that fuel pump out. All right, we've already got the electrical disconnected and next we're going to take off the actual fuel line. Now, of course, ours has not been operating correctly. It does not have any pressure, so there's no big deal. But if you were taking off your tank and yours had been priming, it's going to have 43 PSI there. So you need to be careful, otherwise it's going to spray you and everything around you. Other than that, there's two breather lines all the way at the back. Pull those free. Now we can lower it down and take out that rear pivot bolt. Then she'll lift right off. Now when you lift the tank off, there's actually a spacer that's inside of the tank. You want to make sure you don't lose that. All right, let's flip it upside down and remove the actual pump. Now, fortunately for me, there was only a gallon or two left in this tank. If yours was full, I would suggest that you open it up and siphon out as much as you can get out, because trying to wrestle around a tank that's full of fuel, that's a little bit too much for anybody to deal with, because you're talking about, I don't know, 50, 60 pounds maybe? More than I want to deal with. There she is. All right, so we've got it out, and the last connection I want to look at is actually right here, because this wire actually travels right up to the positive side of the motor itself. So I'm just going to do a resistance check, going from ground to that line. It should read somewhere just a little over an ohm. And guess what? It doesn't read anything. Now, actually, I probably could have tested this with it still in the fuel tank. I wanted to get it all the way out because I have seen them where they had a bad connection right here, but that is not the case. And there's an open circuit. So that tells me that my motor's gone. And here's the trick. With Suzuki, you can order every single individual piece except the actual pump itself. So for me to fix this, I'm gonna have to replace the entire assembly because that is the only way you can get the pump. All right, guys, here it is, straight from Partzilla. What I wanted to show y'all was what the reading should look like on a pump that is working properly. Brand new, ready to go. All right, flip our meter on. Same thing we did on the other one. Just going to this ground and then over to this blue wire. Let's see what we've got. Yep, a little over an ohm. Just for fun, keep that on the ground and go to your fuel level. Watch this. All right, it's at 4.2. It'll probably ramp up to around 40 as I move it up. 50, 80. Yeah, that's running through its whole range right there. But we weren't concerned with that because the fuel level actually worked. But this is what one would look like if it were in a working condition. As I said before, we can't replace just the motor. We have to replace the entire assembly. So let's get it popped back in. It's just going to be the reverse of what we did. Let me go grab the fuel tank, get it put in place, then we'll get it back on the machine. Don't forget to put this back in. Let's tilt her back. Let's get our vent lines back at the back. Make our fuel line connection. Just pushes on. Make sure those little plastic tabs are lined up where they go inside the collar. And then make our electrical connection. Now, let's see if we hear a prime up now. That's what we were looking for, right there. Let's cut it off, prime it up one more time. All right, let's see if she starts. Well, she starts up, but I can tell you right now, I've still got a few other issues. Well, that's as far as we're gonna take it on this particular video. Well, listen, if you need any of the parts that we used to get it this far, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. Till next time, we just wanna say thanks for watching.